So the correct answer in this case is choice D, vitamin B12 deficiency. Now let's look at some of the features that make choice D the best answer here. On the sagittal view, you can see there's a long segment of abnormal T2 signal involving the posterior aspect of the spinal cord. And that can be better seen on the selective cross-sectional image on C3 and C5 on this T2 weighted image. You can see there's this very distinct pattern of symmetric involvement of the dorsal column. And that is a key feature. There is relatively short list of differential diagnosis for lesion that can do this. In this case, this is due to vitamin B12 deficiency causing subacute combined degeneration. So essentially, any cause that can cause vitamin B12 deficiency can do this. So this very distinct symmetric dorsal column involvement. Just a quick review of the dorsal column pathway. I know everyone's dying to know about this. But remember, the dorsal column is part of the ascending sensory pathway. That's why our patient was presenting with a sensory issue to start with. The dorsal column comprises of the two main components. The lateral part is fasciculus cuneatus, and the medial portion is fasciculus dorsalis. And remember, the cuneatus is part of the involving the upper extremity, and the dorsalis is lower extremity. The sensory neuron from periphery extended as the first order neuron into the dorsal root ganglion extending into the posterior column. Then you ascend into medulla. There you would decussate to the other side, connecting with a second order neuron through medial lemniscus, and that would extend into thalamus. At thalamus, you connect it with a third order neuron, and that extends into postcentral gyrus, or the primary sensory cortex. The whole pathway is referred to as dorsal column medial lemniscus pathway. And that is an ascending sensory pathway responsible for light touch or fine touch or discriminatory touch. Remember on your physics exam that you do two-point discrimination? That's part of this pathway. The vibrational sensation as well as proprioception is all associated as part of this pathway. So any type of vitamin B12 deficiency, any cause can do this. In the United States, one of the more common causes is pernicious anemia. Chronic alcoholism can also do this, and various GI disease, Crohn's disease, celiac disease can do that. GI surgery. GI surgery, especially one that affects the terminal ileum, that's where B12 is absorbed, can also cause subacute combined degeneration. A rare but important cause is nitrous oxide abuse or the laughing gas abuse, can also present with this appearance. And that also makes choice C incorrect answer. It's not nitric oxide deficiency, but nitrous oxide abuse, laughing gas abuse. Now, there is a relatively short differential diagnosis for lesion that can cause posterior column abnormality like this. Copper deficiency, vitamin E deficiency can look identical to this. If patients receiving methotrexate treatment, especially intrathecal methotrexate, methotrexate toxicity can present as a dorsal column involvement. If patient has HIV or patient has neurosyphilis with tapis dorsalis can look similar to this. Neurosarcoid can also do this, although neurosarcoid can look like many different things. Typically, you will involve more than just dorsal column. You will see other findings, but certainly neurosarcoid can be in the differential diagnosis. So let's look at some of the answer choices that does not work as well in this case. Choice one, here we are referring to core infarction. Remember, the core is supplied anteriorly by a single anterior spinal artery, posteriorly by a pair spinal artery. By far, the vast majority of core infarction is involvement of the anterior spinal artery. Therefore, the classic appearance for core infarction is presented involvement of the anterior core, often central and bilateral, like in this case. This has that classic L's eye appearance. Rarely, or far less commonly, you can have a posterior spinal artery involvement. In that case, often is presented as a unilateral involvement, not bilateral involvement like in our case. So choice A is not the best answer here. Choice B, vitamin B1 deficiency, thiamine deficiency. That's referred to as Wernicke's encephalopathy. And Wernicke's encephalopathy has that classic appearance of symmetric involvement of bilateral mammary body, periaqueductal grade, bilateral involvement of hypothalamus, as well as involvement adjacent to the third ventricle, with flare signal abnormality, sometimes with restricted diffusion. That would be vitamin B1 deficiency. We already talked about why choice C is not the best answer. For choice E, transverse myelitis. And transverse myelitis can present as a long segment involvement, like in this case of a 8-year-old with a transverse myelitis. However, the classic appearance for transverse myelitis is involvement of essentially entire core with myocore expansion. It'd be very, very unusual to have transverse myelitis to show up with involvement selectively only the dorsal column. So choice E would not make a lot of sense here. That's all for this interesting case, I think. Thank you for your attention and good luck on your exam.